Welcome back to Power BI Helpline YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to explain how you can build Power BI data models with slowly changing dimensions. If you are visiting here for the first time, then please subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for all such interesting topics in Power BI. With that, let's check it out. Slowly changing dimensions basically means one of the attributes of the dimension changes based on time. And you can see here that the department for Sam is department 1 in January, but it is department 2 in February and March. Departments for employees are changing based on time, and with that condition, we won't be able to use this as a dimension table, as there will be a many-to-many relationships between transaction and this dimension table. Here a bridge table is not enough to get proper department in our fact table based on time. So let's solve this data modeling problem. First of all, from Power Query Editor, I will add a department key to this dimension table. We can do that by adding an index column, as in this example, I am starting the index with 1000, but you can choose any index type. We should keep a proper name of this column so that it will be easy to identify. Then I will also create a table with unique list of employee ID. This table will not be used as bridge table, but it will be an independent unique employee dimension. Now we are done with Power Query part of it, and we have to show some DAX magics to see this entire solution working. As that you can see this model, we have unique list of employees, but as said, this bridge table will not work in this time-based department names. So let's delete the relationship between employee table and the department table, and add a calculated column in our transaction table for department ID. I am going to use calculate and filter function for this. Since I have transaction date column here, I will validate the transaction date within start date and end date from department dimension table, and will calculate the department ID accordingly. So the employee's department keys has been calculated, and we can validate this now. And later, I will show you that there is still one problem. So I am selecting one employee ID, for example, employee ID 8, and you can see we have two departments for this employee. Let's validate in our dimension table. In January, it is department ID 1012, but for February and March it has 1008, and same can be validated from our department table. You can notice in the last two rows that we have 1008 for February and March, and 1012 for Jan, and other ID for other months. Now from the modeling view, I can connect these two tables and create one-to-many relationship between department and the transactions table. For slowly changing dimensions perspective, we have solved this problem, and we can start doing visualizations. But the only very small problem is, slicer from employee table will not be in sync with dates, and if we use a slicer from employee table, it will have all the employee names even with no transactions for any selected month. Quickly you can enable this connection as a bidirectional cross-filtering, but as said in our previous videos about ambiguity, I don't want to use this approach, and as usual, I will apply a visual level filter on this slicer, which will bind this slicer to show only if transaction amount is not blank. I already have a total transaction amount measure, which is nothing but just the sum of transactions amount. I will use it to apply this visual level filter for employee name slicer. Now we have solved both the problems. This approach is very useful in many Power BI projects, where dimensions attributes changes over time. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel, and post your questions, feedbacks, and suggestions in comment box.